Hi folks, a bit of a late start today, 20 past 12, well. Acrylic, no idea what I'm going to do, but first of all, it's very, very warm out there, use a spray bottle, so the paint will run, I hope anyway. Let's get some dark, red, blue. More paint spray in there. See what we can make out of this semi-abstract piece of work that's going to come your way. A blue, bit of paint spray. Shouldn't have used that red really. That's vermilion. Very useful colour, but it's a bit obvious on here. So we just get this. Oh, this is a bit of burnt sienna in there. Just going to cover the paper first and then see what we can use. This is a piece of Dale Rowney acrylic paper. Looks very good stuff. Blue. Like a bit more of the spray. It just helps it run up. Cover up around bits we don't like. Might do a sea picture, and why not? Good bit of oak, a bit of a ochre in there. The one I did yesterday, the Quiberon one, I didn't give up on it. I worked it to a finish, and some of my friends on Facebook, on WhatsApp, they love it. They love the abstraction of it. So there we are. You never know what I did, and they did. We've got our WhatsApp group called, we've got two. The last of the summer wine, which is about where we are, isn't it? My age. And the other one is the Cycle Boys. But we didn't go cycling this week because it was a bit iffy. We gave it a miss. Let's put out some more paint in there. I don't like that top. So the paper has expanded a bit, but we expect that because it is paper. So with this acrylic, it's turning out to be rough is best. We've gone into that again. That's all right, it's good for that. It's going to be about 27, 28 today. Should be out there with your Barbie. Right, let's get some low down stuff. River Horizon. I'll just sort of work with this till I've got something that is passable. I can find some more paints, great. That seems to be the answer. Paints grey. There we are. It's all sticky inside. I do like paints grey, some more ultramarine. That's drying out too much really. Let's have a bit of white. I've got a graduate white. Oh, pull the bit of plastic off. There we go. And back in. Back in again on this sky. Oh. You never know what people are going to like. Some like pretty, some like rough. I like rough. Right, let's put a bit of texture in there. Texture. Not things, shapes. Not things. But that's only my bit of advice as I am at the moment. Want some life in those dark bits up above. Right, now I'm going to put in a bit of a... I'm going to bring that down a bit. Just have fun with your paint. Right, then we want a darker colour for the horizon. Ooh, up the hills over the dales. Look at the paper, it's all sort of buckled. It's going downhill. I had busy on my neck this morning. First time I tried osteopathy and that didn't work. But so I've got a series of reasonable exercises. I haven't got a trapped nerve. It was all up my left hand side of my neck. And it's been not very good. All right, let's get some rough sea in there. Turn it down a little bit. Might really help if I put some rocks in, wouldn't it? So we want the rock brush. Yeah. Well, oops, I'll use this nice one here. We'll have We need a bit of light first. To bounce off of. Right, and then we get some colours. Ochre, that's almost dry. We just bung them in. Just rough. Don't worry about form at the moment. We'll do that later when we've got a shape going into that water. Very nice colour, burnt sienna. Could go over that. Just the rocks going out to the sea. Maybe overcast. Just add some colour. Add a bit of red in there. It's a bit too red. There are rocks that are sort of a alizarin colour on the Cornish coast. With the oars. Finals. Bring that down to the sea. We can have a nice bit of sea in there. The ochre, lovely, the burnt sienna. Matching the sky. Oh, a bit of light in there. There'll be no green in this one. Okay, that's nice and formed. Right, let's just wash these brushes. A shake, squeeze, and then back into the sea. So here we go. I'll drag over the see if that horizon. Bit of ochre in there. Oh, I do like doing this. Same with oil. Some wilder stuff in here. take the brush strokes in the direction of where the waves are banging up. Different colours of sky. Red. I don't help myself really by sitting down crouched over this. She's a very nice physio, young lady. Crushing all the way down here. Get some dark stuff in there. Very sad about that young girl who got hit by a driver near where the Wimbledon tennis is going on. Died. It's awful. I know the area very well. A bit of wet rock. We're liking that. Right, let's get some sky colours. I am fighting the shape of the paper now. There's a bit of shadow in here. Highlight the water, the spray. That's good or bad. Cramping my fingers. Let's get a bit of towel in. Now, I know it's very, very dry out there, but the paint stayed nice and moist in the palette. All right, let's get some light back around there. I don't really want to muck about those rocks, I quite like them. I think we're okay there. Uh-huh. must get a little bit of that sienna colouring in here, reflecting some of that sky. And then the dark. I'm hitting a lump there. Breeze coming through my windows. Okay, well, I don't think I could do much more than that. I'll put a mount on it. Oops. Ooh. Bring the brushes together. Out. Oh, I'm going to put the mount there, I think. Well, that's quite dramatic, isn't it? That's very Dave Usher. I hope you enjoyed that little journey down to the Cornish coast. Been there many, many times. It's going further over there. I quite like that. Well, I hope you do too, folks. Thank you for watching. Just remember that rough is valid. Rough, abstract. Just go for it. It's good fun, and then you lose it and you find it, then you lose it again and you find it, and eventually it all works out. Well, hopefully. So I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for phoning. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.